टुडे वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द रेस्ट पोर्शन ऑफ द चैप्टर द इमेज. ओके, सो वी हैव सीन दैट स्ट्रेंजर हैज कम एंड ही हैज टोल्ड टू पुट अ सैंडल पेस्ट ऑन द इमेज, मेन इमेज, बिकॉज ही वॉज हैविंग द डाउट दैट दैट स्टोन यूज फॉर द मेन इमेज वॉज हैविंग सम डिफेक्ट. सो वॉट ही हैज डन, ही हैज स्मियर्ड. What is the meaning of smeared? Smeared means dab, means to apply. Okay, he has applied the sandal paste on the image, and he told it. By saying this, the crowd asked him derisively. What is the meaning of derisively? As if showing the contempt, means everyone was having the doubt that what he is trying to do. What he is up to, because everyone was thinking that he has they were not confident. Crowd was having the doubt that what he is doing, that is right or wrong. So they have asked this question. Then the stranger has replied that they have to wait for the sandal paste to be dried up, but then again he added with that the whole sandal paste will be dried up except the place around the navel. Okay, except the place around the navel, because the place, that is only the place where defect is having the stone. And the stranger also told that if they will wait for the place around the navel to be dried up, then they have to wait for their whole long life. Okay, then by seeing this, they have waited for a while, but it doesn't dried up, the sandal paste doesn't dried up. By seeing this, the sculptor was sad. Jagnachari was sad, was grimly, sculptor said grimly. What he said and why he was sad, because he was going to break the rule. That rule was thing was that he had never allowed anyone to touch the image or touch the sculpture whichever he has made. But now it is the time, because he has proved, the stranger has proved what he has said, that there is a defect in that image. So to go in a detail, to go to really found out what defect is there, he has given the mallet. Student, underline the word here, mallet. What is a mallet? A heavy wooden hammer. He has given the hammer and the chisel to break the image around the place where defect has been found, where the sandal paste haven't dried up. So he was not ready to break, but after lots of insistence, Jagnachari was insisting him, was forcefully telling him to do that, because he want to see that. And after so much of insisting, stranger broke that. And what he has seen, everyone has seen, a baffled told. What student, underline the word baffled. Baffled mean confused, a little baffled told, pipped. Pipped means looking out. Okay, peeping, looking out. A toad was found from that, and by this Jagnachari was broken heart, and he was red. He snatched the sword among the from a soldier who was standing in the crowd to cut off his arm, as he vowed this before. Okay, but stranger twisted his wrist. He has twisted in such a manner that his fingers get unfolded and sword fell down. And he appealed, the stranger appealed that to the crowd, that after he will leave from here, the crowd must stop him from doing this, stop the Jagnachari from cutting off his arm, because his intention was not to make him guilt. His stranger's intention was not to not to make anyone, not to make a Jagnachari what fell down or to cut off his arm. He has just come. He was passing by the way, and he was allured by the beauty of the temple and images which has been carved very beautifully. And all of a sudden, he saw the main image and he found something wrong in that. That's why he just informed in order that is that's in future no one would worship such an image in which defect is there. Okay, so when he was about to leave, Jagnachari asked him that from which place he belong and what is his name. And this old question he has asked, he has put to him. Then stranger said that he belonged to the place Kridharpura. Kridhapura. Then by listening this word, this name Kridhapura, the old man means that old sculptor was became reflective. Why reflective? Reflective means when you have heard or when you are known to that place, you know that place. Everyone's it's a normal reaction that get curious. The man also get curious that then again he put the further question that who is his father? Then the stranger said he don't know. Because a month before his birth, his father all of a sudden left home and never came back, never returned. And by asking the fa his father's name, he said that his name was Krishna Deva. The stranger replied his father's name was Krishna Deva. And by listening this, he's strange old man started telling the story that and in the search of his passion, in the search of the things which he like most, he has left the home and never returned back, and he consider him as a absconder. Student, underline the word here, absconder. Here the meaning is given here, one who leave from a place without informing anybody, continue to be no without informing anybody, only till here it is. Okay, so he has consider himself as absconder because he has not informed his family and he left silently and never returned back. He himself was thinking that it is a offense that he has made. Okay, and this was not a correct way to do. But he also gave explanation that he has a life in the serv and he has done this for the a life in the service of God, for serving the God. The choice, he just explaining that there was no choice. The choice was between the family and attachment and utter dedication. And no, according to the Jagnachari, there was no middle way, no middle path to choose, so he has just decided to leave and never look back with regret because God's above and the king below have been kind. Means the God who is above, means supreme power, is also kind on has been kind, and the king in which king the king of that king of that of that city or that state, whatever, is also kind to him. That's why he never felt that he has done anything wrong. He was happily living there. Okay, this explanation he has given to his boy, that stranger. Yes, then after listening this, that stranger was so surprised and he asked, how did he know these all things about Krishna Deva? Then he said, I myself is Krishna Deva. I changed my name as Jagnachari just to hide my identity from the others. An hour later, he asked his son, that is, now it has been came in the front of everyone that the stranger was none other than his own son. And he said in our letter that he want to go home, and he was taken home by his son. He was sent very comfortably, but he was secretly unhappy. Why unhappy? Why Jatnachari was unhappy? He was unhappy because he was going home where he was very happy. See, it is written here, for he was essentially a creature who throve. Student, underline the word here, throve. It is given here. Continued to be happy and successful. The where he has left the home much earlier, and he was happily living. He loved his work, what work he was doing till now. He was so happy and involved in that only, happily. But now it is time to go back to home because he has been proved wrong. Okay. And he has told this also, that he is not going to cut off his arm, but he is never going to do this work again in his life. So he want to go home, and he was going home, but secretly unhappy because he was leaving his work forever and moving back to his home. He's written his separation from his work as agonizing. What is the meaning of agonizing? To worry or think for long time about difficult problem and situation. Jagnachari was having a feeling that he has been withered away. Student, underline the word withered away. Withered away means became weaker little by little before disappearing completely. Means slowly, slowly, a thing which is moving away. Means he was in that condition. He is thinking himself that he was in that condition, or he is in that condition, that he has compared himself like he is a plant and he is not getting the sunlight which is much needed to grow a plant. The same way, he is moving away from his passion. What was his passion? His passion was to carve the stone. Okay, and that was that he was leaving, he has left or leaving and had returned back to the Kridhapura. Okay, but all of a sudden, after few months of return, means few months had passed away, then he has been commanded by the king to build a temple in Kridhapura to dedicate the Keshava, and he obeyed that happily. And afterward, the name of Kridhapura was changed to Kaidala, which means restored arm. Now today, the Kaidala is in obscure. What is obscure? Not well known. It is not very famous. Okay. And it is a few miles off the Tumkur. It is known as has to have been the capital of the state at one time. Means once it has been the capital of that. Nothing of the ancient glory is not left except the temple with his magnificent Keshava, which stand even today to commemorate the Rizukations, an artist. Rizukations means start a new life. Means this was a start of a new life for an artist. And here, who's an artist? Jagnachari. Okay, students. So you all understood the chapter. Now do the question answer and send it to me. Both A, this one, and B, both. And send it to me on my personal number. Thank you.